thyroid gland, today we're going to talk about the thyroid gland, thyrotoxicosis and thyroid cancer. One of the common questions which everyone asks is that I have a thyroid problem. Do you think that this is a thyroid cancer? So the fear of cancer is very high in our mind. At the same time, we see all around a lot of people who are diagnosed with thyroid disease and taking some treatment for thyroid disease. Now let us understand what is actually a thyroid disease or so-called thyroid problem. Thyroid is very important for our functioning. It is a small gland in front of our neck. It is 25 gram in weight. It is butterfly shaped. Actually, it secretes a substance called as thyroxine, and this thyroxine acts as a catalyst for us. So if it is more in quantity, we will have blood pressure rising, pulse rate rising, we will probably have very anxious movements, we will have palpitations like heartbeats running fast. If it is less, we will become lethargic, will not be really interested in things. So it is a subtle kind of movement, and both the diseases are at the end of its spectrum. But mind well that both of these diseases are not known causes of thyroid cancer. They do not cause itself a thyroid cancer. Thyroid cancer is a disease which arises in a nodule, and these nodules can form without any reason. Multinodular goiter, which is very common, more common than low thyroid or high thyroid, which is called as hypothyroidism or hyperthyroidism, is more common. It is estimated that almost 30% of people, 30% of all of us, will have a thyroid nodule. So that doesn't mean that we will have a thyroid cancer. So it is not also important for every thyroid nodule to undergo the knife. It is not important. It is definitely something which we should not really do, or should not go to doctor or get the thyroid nodule removed, because it is possibly not cancerous, and this possibility is very high that it will not be cancerous. So how does this work? Is it a very lethal cancer? No, it is not at all lethal cancer. 95% of thyroid cancers are differentiated thyroid cancers, means they look like the original gland. The thyroid gland has a typical look which is seen under the microscope, and these thyroid cancers are little variations of the same. So they are also taking up the same iodine, which actually is important for making that hormone, and we can very easily give that iodine with some radioisotope attached to it and can get it killed. And also the surgical treatment is primary for thyroid cancer. So in a nutshell, we actually are blaming the environment for thyroid cancer. We are saying that most of the radiations which are all around us, it is very difficult for us to avoid. It is difficult for us to point out, saying that which radiation is really leading us to thyroid cancer, are possibly increasing this incidence of thyroid cancer. It has increased rapidly in last particularly 10 years. And again, in spite of increase in thyroid cancer incidence, the mortality, means the death from this disease, is not really increased. It is very less. Actually, it is considered that less than 0.5%, or rather 0.5% people will die after diagnosis of thyroid cancer. So it is one of the curable cancer, totally curable cancer, and the treatment commonly is removal of thyroid gland. Most of the times, if the cancer is bigger than 2 centimeters in size, the total thyroid gland is removed, preserving the voice cord nerves, which go bilaterally just below it. They are very well preserved, easily preserved. Most of the thyroid surgeons who are used to thyroid surgery will take extra care to preserve them and safeguard them. At the same time, there are 4 glands which are called as parathyroid glands, which are adjacent to it. They have no relation to it, but they actually are very important for calcium metabolism, and that those glands are also preserved during this surgery. So this surgery, after this surgery, sometimes you require radioactive iodine, which is again a one-day treatment, a oral dose of iodine, which is radioactive isotope, is actually taken orally, and patient goes into isolation for 24 hours, and that's the end of the treatment. So it is very simpler treatment compared to other cancers, although the name of cancer itself creates a fear in the mind, but it is not really that scary. So thyroid cancer is mostly curable. It is not very common. Even the increasing incidence also, it doesn't mean that possibly it will really harm that person. Again, hyperthyroidism, which is thyrotoxicosis or a Graves' disease, these are other names for increased thyroid hormone, is not really a cause for thyroid cancer, although it is a little more, 6 to 8% of thyrotoxicosis patients will have a thyroid cancer in it. One very small another note is that there is something called as Hashimoto's thyroiditis. Thyroiditis means infection of thyroid. This is one of the precursor, or you can say condition, where thyroid cancer is actually precipitated by this condition. And this is an autoimmune disease which is not in our control as such. So how do we prevent it? We can prevent it by not really working around conditions where there is most of the radiation fields are there. It is definitely known to have more increased incidence because of the radiation field, although it is hardly possible for any of us to prevent the radiation fields around because of the mobiles used so common around. There is a brief note about other cancers which are also called as thyroid cancer. Those are two cancers which are very lethal. They are anaplastic thyroid cancer, and another is a medullary thyroid cancer. These are two different cancers. They are compiled into thyroid cancer because they arise from a thyroid gland. They behave completely different. Anaplastic cancer, which is generally comes in old age, and it is with the hoarseness of voice, breathing difficulty, is very rapidly growing cancer, not very good cancer. It has very bad prognosis. Medullary thyroid cancer is again sometimes genetically predetermined, and in that, if it is genetically predetermined, we have to know that if your family member is having this cancer, then must have a genetic opinion or genetic counseling, because it can be prevented. It can be prevented if the surgery for thyroid is done very early in the life, and the incidence or familial incidence is a tune of almost 90%. So those people have to take immediate opinion of genetic counselor, and they have a definitely require surgery and has a complete different pathway for the treatment.